Thanks Sidekick for sponsoring today's video. So I made this video about Google Calendar tricks and tips to enhance your productivity, and you guys seem to love it. So here's one on advanced Notion tips to skyrocket your productivity. We'll be discussing 9 different ways to improve the way you're using Notion and make your organization process that much efficient. So let's get started with number 1, and that means we'll start with a really good one. So Trove is a free extension you can install right into your browser, which allows you to create highlights and write comments right from your browser while you are searching for information around the web. Then all of those comments and highlights are seamlessly exported to a Notion page or database of your choice, and you don't even have to leave the window where you're working. It's a great resource for anyone who references the web a lot and uses Notion as a knowledge base or as a note-taking or writing app. And here's something interesting as well. While you're using Trove, the highlights and comments you've just created will remain on the annotated webpage, so whenever you return, you can see exactly where you were working. For hardcore Notion users who've decided to basically export their entire lives into Notion, it can be a bit overwhelming to find a good system to organize most viewed pages and have a dedicated place to look at more relevant information and check up on progress you need to make in a lot of relevant pages. That's why creating or importing a dashboard template can be so important. With a customized dashboard, you can create shortcuts to your most viewed pages and organize them as you would organize any other page. You can create a list for pages you need to update on a daily or weekly basis, for instance, highlight projects you're currently working on, or even have a section for quick notes, just like I have here. Although you can always create your own dashboard from scratch, there are a lot of different pre-made ones that you can always duplicate into your own workspace, and which I will link down below. Notion allows you to incorporate icons into pages, which can be really useful if you want to use a color code or a visual reference guide for the content inside your pages. However, as time goes by, using emojis for all of your pages can look a little bit chaotic, and that's why with a little bit of research, you can find several free icon packs in the internet you can use for free. If you like a more minimal vibe, you can find a great icon pack in Notion VIP, which is the one I personally use and I love it. To change your icons, all you have to do is copy the corresponding URL in the icon list, and then paste the link in the icon embed window, and that's it! Your Notion workspace will have a more cohesive aesthetic and it can make things a little bit more fun to organize. Just like I mentioned in the Google Calendar tips video, it's important to master your software, and if you want to use Notion in a smart way, a good place to start is memorizing your shortcuts. Because this is very self-explanatory, I'll leave a link with Notion's most useful keyboard shortcuts down below, such as creating new pages, toggling the sidebar, creating quick headings, and so much more. If you're dealing with long pages in your Notion database or workspace, learning how to format your tags with heading blocks and then insert a table of contents right at the top of your page can be a lifesaver. Notion features an automatic table of contents block that is very similar to how a Word table of contents works. You just have to format the text accordingly, using different headings to create hierarchy, and then Notion will do the rest of the work for you. If you're using Notion as a note-taking app, knowledge base, or a writing app, then having a table of contents will provide immense value to your work. If you're using Notion as a task management resource and using it to manage your work on a daily basis, as well as appointments, chores, and other events, then it can be a good idea to spend some time developing a major database for all tasks that has the power to filter them according to category, date, and also link some tasks to other databases. This is so helpful because it allows you to consolidate several categorized task lists into only one. And to navigate your tasks, all you have to do is create and use filters, and that's it. And if you feel like this is too much of a chore, don't worry, I've linked in the comments down below the task list you're seeing on the screen, so you can duplicate it into your workspace and start using it right now. Notion created a special type of block called Global Block last year, so you can use a block on multiple pages of your workspace. You can create these global or sync blocks using the drop-down menu and by copying them and pasting them to other pages or page sections. Every time you want to update your block, all you have to do is edit it as you would any other regular block, and all other copies will sync automatically. Almost everyone knows that Notion features a reminder system, allowing you to integrate some nifty time management tools to your knowledge database. However, reminders are a bit more powerful than they seem on the surface. When introducing a reminder, you need to type @ and you'll be prompted to follow it by a date, but you can also use the words today, tomorrow, or yesterday to make the process quicker. You can also type right away the date and Notion will automatically add a timestamp. However, to turn those dates into reminders, you have to click the date to format it and set up the reminder, picking the time when you want Notion to send you a notification to tell you it's time to get your work. And for a quick workaround, you can always type @reminder followed by a time, date, or both to write down that reminder in line without further formatting options. Once you start using databases in Notion, you'll be so addicted, you won't use any other blocks ever again. Linked databases bring this to a whole new level. Basically, you can include synced copies of the same content across different pages, which is great if you want to use filters in different instances of your workspaces. Linked databases are really powerful because they basically connect your whole information throughout. Here's actually a good example. In this project database, I'm able to link to a database that includes pages from a tasks list. Then, in the task list, I can see which projects are assigned to certain tasks. All of this is clickable, so moving around different databases is incredibly easy, and I never have to worry about migrating information from one place to other. We're all fans of efficiency in this channel, and Notion is a great example of something that helps you avoid unnecessary clutter in your daily life. The same thing happens to a lot of information we find across the internet. A lot of it is unnecessary, has lack of research, is unfiltered, and actually doesn't have a lot of views. So right now, my news on productivity and lifestyle are all delivered with a simple and useful Sidekick email. I signed up for Sidekick for free to get a newsletter twice a week on my phone. It basically searches the internet for my own personal interests and gets me personalized recommendations on the best ways to work, best life habits to form, or best ways to upgrade my living space. If you're looking for tailored information and a way to save time on scrolling through your phone, Sidekick will be your best option. It's completely free, takes 15 seconds to subscribe, and well, it's basically great. So you can click the link down below to get your free newsletter, and that's it. As simple as that. I really hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you like this content, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Bye, guys.